best part. It's so hard to choose.
It's actually 40,000 citizens, but I've lived here for a long time. I've lived here as a student. I've lived here as actually like a landlord, like I've rented before.
You're gonna have a community already there kind of waiting for you. My name's Carrie Gibbons and I live in Provo.
How long did you live there?
2 years.
My name is Taft Julian and I've been living in a redstone complex for just under a year now. Some of the positives, the prices are low. I mean, I kind of moved in here because the prices were so good. Mm-hmm. It was close to campus. I'm with friends. We have a great ward where it's just like this apartment complex and then two others, and you know, we're close-knit. We live close to each other. Mm-hmm. We have a ton of resources available. It's kind of just like an amazing community that they've set up here.
I'm a volunteer. I represent District 5 as their chair. District 5 is comprised of 8 neighborhoods.
The American dream into reality. As Utah's third largest city and the largest city in Utah County, Provo's estimated population is more than 116,000 people.
It's an investment for all of us.
Now more than ever, buying a home is becoming more of an opportunity to build wealth.
We moved back here and Provo we identified as really kind of like the only place that we could see ourselves living in Utah, mostly due to like walkability and having an actual like city center. So much of Utah as a whole, and especially Utah County. Positives of Provo housing that I see are that I think that there is more of a drive for high density.
Not needing to worry about everything. There's so much taken care of. It's not really like a bunch of separate charges on the rent, right? You sort of just pay one rent. It's, you know, they keep it cheap, well, you know, as much as they can. Best part about being in Provo, I think, is just being near BYU. The proximity is really great. There's so many fun events that go on campus. And just being able to like be here and be a part of that, pretty cheap. I mean, I couldn't ask for much cheaper. For, you know, you actually get pretty decent quality. Mm-hmm. It's a really comfortable space. There's enough just room here. We have 2 fridges, which is, I don't know if you understand the gravity of that, but that's amazing. Having 2 fridges makes all the difference. So it's hard to complain. If you haven't thought about living in Redstone, I would consider it. It's like one big family. You know that you always got support when you need it, which is really nice.
I just want to say, as the District 5 chair, that students really like, you should be involved in Provo City government. I think this is something that obviously the issues that students are experiencing with off-campus housing, and we're always looking for student voices. Like, it is my job to represent not only District 5, like, to the city council, but it is my job to know what's going on in the neighborhood and report that back to the city council. I've seen it from many different angles. Yeah, even the comments about, like, you have to earn your way into the neighborhood, like, it left me shocked and aghast. Are you kidding me? Like, are we saving the neighborhoods for high-income people who have, quote, earned it? Like, is that how we feel about high-density housing?
Is this on? Hello? Testing.
What's your name?
My name is Taft Julian.
And how long have you lived at a Redstone apartment?
I've lived here at a complex that belongs to Redstone since August, so we're coming up on a year pretty soon here.
We understand that you've had some experiences with a difficult property manager. Tell us about that.
Yeah, We had a really difficult property manager that he made living here so hard, you know. He was really friendly and energetic when we would go to him in person. And then we would email him, we would text him. He would take days, you know, sometimes weeks to respond. If he did, he always responded in a really passive-aggressive way. And then just living here, you know, we would ask for small things to be fixed, and it just seemed like it never got done. We would go to the office to speak to him. During the hours, he said he'd be there, and he just wouldn't be. He'd say, oh, I stepped out for the afternoon. But he wouldn't tell us, and so it was hard to reach him, hard to get anything done, and it just added a lot of stress to our lives that felt unnecessary. What's it like to live in a redstone complex? That's a lot I'd like to say. I don't know if there's a lot I can say here, but I think just sometimes it feels like you're just one small person, and you can scream and scream all you want and you'll never be heard.
And every time they take over a property, those residents of said property are basically under the Redstone umbrella, meaning that Redstone gets to now decide what prices are charged for rent each month. They get to decide what the renter's insurance looks like. And so basically they get to rewrite the entire lease that a resident signs. And Redstone is notorious for putting hidden passages in these leases that you wouldn't see at the time of signing.
We came to this apartment, right, together, me and a group of friends, and we found out that on our rent we're going to be charged a fee for a renovated apartment. And we came into this apartment and it was filthy. I mean, like, the carpet was filthy. You could pull up the carpet and see the flooring underneath. It was disgusting. So not only was it not renovated, it wasn't cleaned like we were promised it would be, and it was frustrating just to try and, you know, try and make that move in your life and feel like you were unheard.
My name is Laura Levitt, and I am a product designer. I represent District 5 as their chair. District 5 is comprised of 8 neighborhoods. How much do I know about Provo housing? I mean, yeah, I feel like I know a lot. not necessarily in like a Provo City government official sort of a way, but I've lived here for a long time. I've lived here as a student. I've lived here as actually like a landlord, like I've rented before. And I've lived here as like a homeowner. So I've seen it from many different angles.
Have you seen any changes in regards to housing while you've been living in Provo?
I feel like it's becoming much more scarce and more expensive lately. Like, you live in some pretty dumpy, gross places, something like barely legal, you know, just enough to get by city code, and then you're paying a lot. There are so many amazing, like, historic homes that have just been left to rot because somebody acquired them a long time ago and filled them with students.
I think that the ethics of Redstone really is that they view the residents of these properties as dollar signs. The only thing that they're really interested in at Redstone is money. And they're so hyper-focused on growth that they hardly stop to think about the people that they're affecting along the way.
So there's always, there's like that landlord push to like, how can I maximize profits versus what's actually good for a town.
I think it's about time for Redstone to take a hard look at their ethical values.
Yeah, even the comments about like, you have to earn your way into the neighborhood, like, like, that's a paradigm and a perspective that may let you know why high-density housing has been frowned upon and why landlords are able to get away with so much in terms of maybe taking advantage of students. Like, people are seeing this with a perspective and a paradigm that has made it the way it is. And I think it's really valuable and important to try to remove that layer of just, like, this is how it's always been. Try to see it with fresh eyes. Think about what can make it better. Oh, man. I think it's a really good question. I think it's a very difficult question.
My name is Taff Julian, and I've been living in a redstone complex for just under a year now. The prices are low. I mean, I kind of moved in here because the prices were so good. Mm-hmm. It was close to campus. I'm with friends. We have a great ward where it's just like this apartment complex and then two others, and you know, we're close knit. We live close to each other. Mm-hmm. We have a ton of resources available. It's kind of just like an amazing community that they've set up here.
My name is Laura Levitt. I've lived in Provo for 8 years this go around, but I also attended BYU as a student. I represent District 5 as their chair. City meeting recently where somebody wanted to build little apartments in his backyard, which was just approved by the Provo City Council in an effort to address the housing shortage, affordable housing shortage. And he had planned 3 units in his backyard instead of 2. And really it looked pretty unappealing, like it was a lot of concrete. There's like that landlord push to like, how can I maximize profits versus what's actually good for a town.
There's so many fun events that go on campus, and just being able to like be here and be a part of that